Hello and welcome to Whiskey Watch with me, Terry Kay. We've got... Double Wood. I just got wood, I've got Double Wood. It's Belvini. Single malt Scotch whiskey. And we're talking Double Wood, we're talking... well, it says on here, first cask, whiskey oak. And it says many years, hold on a minute, it says many years of maturation exclusively in traditional whiskey oak casks, mellows the maturing spirit and imparts gentle warming, blah, blah, whatever. I don't like to get the taste notes if possible. I think those original casks are bourbon casks. I could be wrong, but it just says whiskey casks here. I could be wrong. And then we've got this second sherry oak casks. A further few months maturation in European oak casks increases complexity, bringing fruity and honeyed blah 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 blah. Again, taste notes. I don't like taste notes. What's the back here say? Distillery remains totally dedicated to traditions, care and craftsmanship. Milksman's Shield is the big shovely thing. It's still an integrated part of the process, back-breaking stuff. And it's used by our four maltsmen, turning the grain on the floor. So they're turned around, they've got their own grain malting and everything else. Malting, what you do with malting is that you've got barley. Inside barley, now, if you're a seed, right, you've got, like, if you're a little seed, you know, this big, well, I mean, they're not this big, but say you're a seed that big, you've got that amount of growth to go before you reach the surface and reach the energy of the sun. So you've got to have a little battery inside you. You've got to have energy. And that's stored, that energy is stored. The best way of storing it is, well, there are other ways, but one of the best ways of storing it is in starch. Starch is in things like potatoes and stuff like that, flour. Stuff like that, it's got starch. You know, it's kind of pretty much starch in it, you know. So what you got in there is you've got starch stored. And you've got some enzymes stored. You've got alpha and beta amylase enzymes. And what happens is you trick them. In normal situation, it rains, gets a bit warm. And then they go, right, we're ready. Wet, warm. Boom, out they come. Top comes out, bottom comes out. Bottom goes into roots. Top comes out. The shell just kind of husks and goes away. But the top comes out, makes its way to the surface. That needs power. You know, and what powers it is the starches, but the starches won't power it on their own. They need converting into nice sugar that will, boom, everything can use sugar, glucose in it. So what happens is, with fruits have got glucose already around the seed. So you block, it drops on the floor, all this glucose is there, the seed goes, thank you, and up it goes. But the barleys and wheats and things like that, they're a little shell, a little hard shell protected. And this, all the stuff is inside. All, it's got its own battery. Excuse me, scratching. I had an injury. And I've got stitches still in there on it, you know. I'm going off the ring here, I know, but I'm kind of just saying that what happens on the malting floor, they trick them into thinking that they're underground and everything's all the right temperature and the right amount of water and everything else. So they start growing. The minute they start growing, they're combing these out so they're not all doing that to each other. They comb them, turn them, comb them and everything else so the temperatures are all right and everything else. They have to do all that. And a lot of it's done by hand. And a lot of it's done in a traditional manner. And if it's done in a traditional manner, the people doing it can see and are in control of what is going on. It's not a machine going and turning things over before they're there. You know, if you're cooking, when you're mixing something, you can see if something ain't quite mixed in. So you'll mix that in and turn it and whatever else. You'll see if something's a bit manky, you'll pull it out and throw it away. The same goes with the seeds in it. So you stop germination. Catch them while they're still, while they're just popping out and just popping out, and you catch them, stop germination, and you catch all those lovely sweet things, and they're the things that turn into the alcohol. And then the alcohol is distilled off with the flavours in it and the flavour oils and everything else. And they're all distilled off around 80 degrees, something like that, I think. 100 degrees, the water boils up with it. Below that, the water stays behind and all the alcohol comes off, and a lot of the aromas and the oils do as well. Certain volatile oils. But, little one. Sorry if I'm going off the remit here. But I'm kind of just going off and kind of saying what's what, and what ain't, and what is. Now, Belvini looks very nice, even in the miniature, looks lovely. I'd love to see if that is given enough time in a sherry oak, because you do want a little bit of the complexities in there as well. It smells nice, even straight off the lid there. I'm going to pour about half of this tiny little one in my tiny glass. There we go, that's about half of that. I'd like to save half of it for later on. That's it. Put him back in, and then I'll talk to you about what kind of aromas I'm getting. Gives it a chance to just sit and settle for a minute or two. Put him away in a minute. Right. Without the water in, just a little down here somewhere. Yeah, can smell all sorts of complexities, all loveliness. Right. Yeah, that smells lovely. It smells glorious. You're getting little tiny chocolatey notes. Kind of nice, sort of 50% cocoa chocolate, or 40% cocoa chocolate. Just coming in up under your nose and tickling at you. You're getting hot cross buns in there as well. Tiny little bit of burnt orange peel. I'm going to throw a little tiny little dab of water in there. One spoonful and a half a spoonful. Twirling round. Lovely. Now I'm starting to get a little nut characters coming out. I'm getting a little bit of walnut. A little bit of... Let's just go in there again. There is another nut in there. Can't place it. A little bit of cashew nut. Ground cashew. Slightly toasted cashew. You know, like, if you have it on certain pastries, you chop up cashews fine, and then you toast them up, or bake them, or whatever. You're getting those notes. You're getting slightly toasted sugar. Little honey background notes. Even with the water in, you're getting quite a nice little hit of alcohol, but in a nice way. And slight, very slight piney resins in there. Cheers, everyone. Chin chin. And Nostravia. Bottoms up. Skull. And Slauncher. Oh, that is nice as well. Wow, that is lovely. sugary notes, kind of brown, like muscovado sugar in there. But dark, something coffee-like almost, like a latte. Not quite the kind of espressos and things like that. Something almost like a latte. It's creamy, latte. It's a vanilla sort of background note. That's nice. That is nice. It tastes fairly strong though. And yet we're only talking 40%. But it does taste punchy. It tastes kind of like the alcohols, you know, quite often when you get like, you get higher bottlings and things, you know, and you get the 40% ones, quite often they kind of taste a little bit, not abused, they kind of taste a little bit weaker for it sometimes. Whereas just a few more, you know, even 3 or 4 more ABVs, and that, you know, you kind of, you're suddenly picking all those flavours up. It gives the alcohol the strength to pick up a bit more flavour, pardon me, and drop it there. Whereas like 40, it's like, oh, I can't manage. 43 just gets a few more fingers around it. To me, to my mind, you know. But I like that. And I think those sherry casks, probably Oloroso sherry casks, I think they're kind of, they are doing their job. They're offering them complexities, they're offering a lot of richness, they're offering a little bit of plumminess, a little bit of prunes in the background, and they're just enough, they're not overdone, they're just enough to kind of make it still a man's drink, but at the same time, I don't mean that in a misogynistic way or anything like that, but it's still a man's drink, but it's it's still glorious and lovely. Still sweet, still tasty, but it's still got a punch and a kick. That's lovely. That is lovely. Well, that little chap there. Dun 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 dun. Belvini, double wood. Yeah, he'll give you double wood. Good lad. Lovely stuff. Cheers, bottoms up, chin chin, Nastrovia, skull, and a slaunchy. Lovely. See you next time. Don't be late. Biddly boo. Bye.